You're live.
All right, guys, we're going to be working the Ghost series. We've been working this for the last couple weeks. We're going to be finishing it up this week, so I want to get through the entire series. For you guys that haven't been doing the series, let's just try the first couple. We're going to do 5-6 different techniques today. If it's too much and it's all below, you just stay with the first two. All right, especially you new guys.
We're going to start with side control.
First thing I want to do is T-Rex my arms. I'm dropping my right elbow down. Right hand is in his hip. My left hand is going to his shoulder and coming underneath his neck. My right knee is going to be tight against his body. If I want to, I can place my foot on my knee as well. The most important part is to stay active against his body. I see a lot of people do this. This is worthless. It's not going to stop Scott from running. Go ahead. Just slide the knee right through and mount me with no problems. Okay, I have to be active with this knee. If I'm active with this knee and he starts driving my knee, I can literally drive my knee through underneath him. So just keep it tight up against his body after you T-Rex, and from here we're gonna shrimp. I'm gonna drop my right leg down. This is just gonna block up until I shrimp. My left knee's tight to my butt. My left foot's tight to my butt. I'm gonna drop my right leg down, lift my hips up off the mat, shrimp away. At this point, my right hand is gonna lock out straight into his hip as I get a wizard with my left arm. Turn a little bit. Okay, so on my side, right hand in the hip, left arm is wizard. I'd like to replace Hacker. I bring my knee in, try to step over and drag it across, but he's going to drive his knee tight into my body to eliminate that space. What I'm going to do when he pushes into me is get an underhook with my right arm across his body. At this point, I'm going to straighten my legs, almost like I'm spooning the side of his hip. From here, I'm going to start to glide my legs across the mat, starting on my right side and then switching to my left until I become parallel with him. My right arm is actually driving my bicep across the back, across his back to his far shoulder. This helps me pop out. And then from here, I'm going to turn in, stomach down, bring my arm through, gable grip underneath his chest. And then from here, I'll come up to my knees, right into sprawl control. Again. T-Rex, right, I put my hand on the shoulder, scoop underneath my chin, his chin, that's fine. Knee active and tight against his body. If I want to rest my right foot to my left knee, that's fine. Okay, up until the point where I'm going to shrimp. I'm going to drop my leg, lift my hips, shrimp to my side. My right arm goes right to his hip as my left arm overhooks. I'd like to be able to drag through to get the half guard at 25 cent, but he's going to slide his knee tight to my body. My right arm will then underhook underneath his body, stay on your side, very important. Spoon him, keeping my legs tight. I'm gonna glide my legs across the mat, switch my hips, don't spin my stomach, continue to glide as I drive my arm across the back of his head. And now once I'm here, I wanna be heavy on his head with my right arm, driving his head down to the floor so it's easy for me to spin to my stomach and gable grip, come up to my knees, pipe the football. These first two that we're going to be working, it's very important that we keep pressure on his head, okay? If the pressure fails and he kind of creates a little bit of space to block the actual transition, which we'll work in a little bit, all right? It's very difficult for me to come up on top or to actually go to the chokes that we're going to work in a little bit, all right? So we'll have to transition and do something else. One more time. Again, dropping my right elbow in. Inside of my forearm and hand to his hip. Left hand comes through his shoulder, slide my elbow underneath his neck, blocking his body with my right knee. Okay, I can put my right foot on my left knee as well if I want. And then from here, I'm gonna lift my hips and shrimp to my side, pimp arm with my right arm, keeping the arm locked out. Dennis, come over here for a second. I don't want this arm to be anything more than 90 degrees. If Scott circles this way, I start losing power and it's very difficult to push off. Come back. I want to make sure it's 90 or less towards my body, my angle. Come back down to your shoulder. I have my wizard. I'm going to move my body tight to his. Right hand underhooks. I'm going to glide my legs, switch my hips, continue to glide. Punch my right arm over his back, heavy on his head.
spin to my stomach, stay sprawled out, secure the over-under first, then come up to my knees. All right, I don't want to come up to my knees as I'm securing or come up to my knees and then secure, because then he can hand fight. Okay, questions? All right, let's go.
All right, okay guys, come on. All right, again, we're gonna T-Rex. Keep our knee tight to his body. Keep this active, don't get lazy, don't do this. Knee tight to the body. My right foot to my left knee if I want, as long as I'm making contact to his body. All right, I'm gonna drop my hips, or lift my hips, drop my legs, shirt my hips to the side, wizard hip bar. This time, as I bring my legs up and under hook, I'm gonna swing, coming to this parallel position, heavy on the head, okay? This time, I'm gonna keep my arm heavy on his head. I'm not gonna come up to sprawl control. I'm gonna take my left arm, bring it all the way under my right, and up. So the back of my hand is facing towards his hips. From here, my right hand is gonna turn and slide to a gable grip. Once I do this, I'm gonna open my legs, turn my right leg up, use my left forearm to push off, and bring my head up onto his back. At this point, I'm gonna do the hurrah, and I'm gonna lift my left elbow and cinch my arm across. So my elbow's up towards the ceiling now, and my left forearm is close to parallel to the floor as possible. I'm then gonna open my left hand, slide my right bicep to my palm, and now as I do that, I want to push his head down and then walk my hand all the way to his lat and armpit, keeping my head up high, and now I'm gonna squeeze my elbows together, pull tight to my chest to finish the Mars or inverted Darce choke.
One more time, let's go, another angle.
T-Rex, shrimp, wizard pimp arm, underhook. Swing the legs, heavy on the head, trade the hands, switch to the gable, pop my head out, switch my legs, stay on my side, lift my elbow to the ceiling, open my left hand, drive his head down as I bring my bicep to my palm, squeezing my elbows together, pulling tight to my chest. Okay, right to the inverted Darce. Okay, stop it, we're gonna do the Darce roll off the inverted Darce choke or the Mars. I'm gonna drop my right elbow down, hand to his shoulder underneath, okay? Knee checking his body, foot to my knee, okay? Everything's accumulative, make sure we keep doing this. All right, I'm gonna lift my hips, strip away, wizard pimp arm, get the underhook, swing my parallel position, keeping pressure down on his head, training my arms, establishing my gable grip, popping my head out, opening my hand, cinching in the choke. Now, once I'm here, one of the things Scott wants to do to escape is drive into me, put me flat on my back, and bring his arm over my body, essentially stopping and nullifying the choke. What we want to do from this position, once we establish the choke, is when I feel him pressure into me, I want to set my driver with my left leg. I'm going to do a crescent kick with my right all the way through, and then switch to my stomach, slide out, elbows together, tight to my chest, making sure I'm keeping him on his side. When my footwork, once I have the choke, is I'm setting my driver with my left leg, my driver being this is my palm leg, I'm gonna push off of this to roll up and over, crescent kicking with my right leg, all right? Setting my kickstand. This prevents him from rolling back up to his belly, okay? This is a block. And then from here, I'll step through, slide my hips back, turn my head toward his hips, elbows together, tight to my chest. One more time. Shrimping, wizard pimp arm, underhook, swing my legs, keeping into my parallel position, heavy on his head, trading my hands, popping my head out, hurrah, cinching my choke. He drives in and he set my driver, swing, slide up and back, looking at his hips, elbows together, tight to my chest, finishing with the topside Darce. Okay, the theme with the first two, going to sprawl control or doing the Darce or the Darce or inverted Darce or Darce roll to the topside Darce, okay, is keeping heavy on his head.
What will happen is once he realizes I'm trying to keep his head down as I'm transitioning to that parallel position, okay, he's gonna create just a little tiny window of space so he can get his hand over, okay? When that happens, there's an opportunity for me to establish an underhook, and it's gonna allow me to come all the way through the butterfly guard. Let's go this side. Swing, parallel position. I try to go heavy on his head, but he's gonna pop up just a little bit, because what he wants to do is bring that arm across and settle him. So as soon as I get here, I feel him lift his head up just a little bit. I'm just gonna switch my right arm to an underhook. Stay on my side. My right leg is going to thread in, establish a butterfly hook, and I'll pull my left leg through, sit right up in the butterfly guard with my over-unders. I'm going to ghost right through butterfly guard now, okay? Establish the lizard pimp arm, underhook, glide, swing, punch over the head. Try to go heavy on the head, but he pulls his head up. Establish the underhook, stay on my side, thread the needle, right foot through, establishes the butterfly hook, pull my left foot through, sitting right up in the butterfly guard with over-unders, keeping active hooks. Go this way. Getting the under. Gliding across the mat, heavy on his head. He creates a little bit of space. He wants to pull that arm over. Very important. Hang on to that arm with that wizard, that overhook. Don't let him pull it across. Switch to the under. Continue to step through. Thread the needle. Get my butterfly hook. Pull my left leg through. Sit up right into the butterfly guard with my over-unders. T-Rex, right knee blocks the hip, or blocks his body. I'm gonna lift my hips, strip weight, my wizard pimp arm, underhook. As I start to swing, he blocks, sets his hips back. I now gonna switch my arms, going from the wizard that I had with my left and the underhook to the right, I'm gonna switch. Wizard with the right, underhook the head. And now, I'm just gonna reverse my swing, come back, arm drag, punch over his hip, over under, get both of my hooks, align our spine, sit my butt back over his heels, pull up on his over-unders, break him down, and when I break him down, make sure I'm getting my hips in front of my knees, making babies to the small of his back. Okay, doing the specter, okay, the reverse ghost, bring the knee in, a shrimp, wizard pimp arm, as I swing, he blocks the near hip, gets heavy, I switch hands, reverse direction, swing back, punch over, arm drag through, get the over under, right hook, left hook, align my spine, sitting my butt back over his heels, pulling up on the over under as I break him down, getting my hips in front of my knees, making babies to the small of his back. Let's take it back. We can also do this. Use it to slide right in, go right to the truck as well. All right, guys, we're gonna do some troubleshooting. One of the questions I always get is, well, can he, when I go for the wizard pimp arm, can he just do a step over armbar?
Or a far side armbar?
Yes, he can get a far side armbar if I do absolutely nothing. Okay, once I trip, get a wizard.
If I just hang out here at the wizard pimp arm, if I do absolutely nothing else at this point and hang out here, yeah, he can get a far side armbar. He's gonna stuff my head, step over, take the other. Okay? But the second I feel him moving, he actually moves into the same direction I need to go parallel. Okay? So as he goes for the armbar, as long as I keep that underhook and I pressure with that underhook and punch it through, I have no problem turning the corner. Okay, so when Scott goes for the armbar, once I get to wizard pimp arm, let's kind of angle this way just a little bit. Okay? So as soon as Scott starts to go, I'm gonna underhook up. Okay, he actually turns and faces me. One more time, let's go this side. He stuffs my head, I underhook as soon as he starts to go, swing.
okay?
You'll wind up scrambling right into an open guard situation.